Got a cold sore. Said it's karma. Think I might agree.
What have you got to say, guys, to the world? The whole world.
Save it for later, guys.
YOLO, unless you believe otherwise.
I'm 5'7". I'm 69 kilos. And a blood pressure 160 something. Hey guys, so basically, this is what I meant.
Ow!
What?
No one knows.
Let's talk. Some shit's gone down. I'm on house arrest. Life is really good. And the thing is, I'm fucking bored. This is not extremely accurate, but like I'll say, like, I don't really want to do anything. Like, if I'm not out of friends and shit, I'm like, I just want to sit in bed and watch movies all day. And now I literally have 2 weeks to do that. And I'm just like, so I've written down the things that Hannah's asked me to talk about. But first I want to talk about, I'm so like uncomfortable with myself right now, like I just don't know what to do. I feel so like gross in my own skin. Anyway, I want to talk about how I actually don't understand why, like, just general sexuality. Like, I don't get why it's so ingrained in society that, like, it's a bad thing to, like, do stuff. I just don't get it. Like, I just don't, like, why is it that deep? It's literally fun. Like, people literally do it to, like, feel good and have a good time. Why is that a bad thing? Obviously, it's, like, oppression of, like, people and their choices and their like autonomy and shit, but it's just like, I don't get it. Anyway, the meaning of life. I'm really not in the fucking, like, the meaning of life, I think. I don't think there is, really. I don't think that there's something that exists beyond put onto it, like, of life. Like, I think we're just fucking here and that's it, and we're all like purpose and meaning and da da da, because we're so sad. Life is just quite shit. There has to be a reason why we're here, to endure all of this just shit. Therefore, purpose, meaning. When it's like, we're not, there's not supposed to be this much shit. Fucking, we were talking about this in politics the other day. And they were literally sitting there being like, capitalism is like the natural progression of humans. There is nothing natural about a capitalist society. It's disgusting, it's gross, it's not what humans should be doing. So no wonder we're all fucking miserable, because this, the world in which we live in is not, you know, I mean, we've just fucked it all up. So we're all miserable and we're all like, oh my God. It's like, no wonder. So I think we're all at this point where we're like, we all need a purpose, we all need a reason, which is fine, but it's not fine for the people that don't fucking have one. More time, people's purpose is their job, but it's like a... Like, if you were to sit there and be like, what is your purpose? I'd be like, making films. But it's not, is it? That's just what I want to do with my time. That's just what I want to do in the future. That's not my purpose. Or like, taking pictures. Or like, making people smile, making people laugh. But that's fucking everyone's. Everyone's purpose is to make people happy and like, make the world a better place. That's just life. That's just what we want to do. That doesn't mean that that is why you're here. You know, you're here because you're here. You're here because your parents had sex and now you're here. So basically there's no meaning to life. We're just here. We just have to put a label on it because life is fucking miserable and shit. So, it's all good. I just miss my lady.
Okay. I thought I would do an update. Just, I don't know, I feel like documenting how I feel. I look good though.
I did this like 4 days ago and I still haven't done the other hand. Now, get it together. How am I doing? Not good. So, as soon as I start recording, I get so self-aware of my voice. I want to make something that is not directly to do with what is happening at the moment in terms of my life, because I don't want to think about that. So I'm going to talk about the films that I've been watching recently, because there's a lot of them. I've watched like 12 films in the last week, and I think that I have a new favourite film. The film is called Come On, Come On, and it's got Joaquin Phoenix in it, and it's directed by Mike Mills. It came out last year, and it basically follows the guy that Joaquin plays. I've already forgotten his name, but it follows this guy. And basically, he comes to help out his sister, who he doesn't really talk to anymore, because her husband is insane, and she needs someone to look after her son. So then this guy comes in and starts taking care of his nephew, and it's basically about the relationship between adults and children, and it just follows their reconnection of their relationship. I fucking loved the film, like, so much. I thought it was just, it was all shot in black and white, which I think can become cringe, but I think it was done in a really nice way that felt warm, and it felt like a drawing, kind of, which I really liked. And it was shot in mainly New York and LA, which are two really like colourful places. And so I think using black and white made it even more interesting. Yeah, I feel like I always sound really pretentious when I talk about films.
it just was like a really, really gentle, subtle reminder about how beautiful mundane life can be, or like mundane life, just average everyday stuff. I think the cinematographer and the director did that so well, because it was like, this is just normality, right? But there's so much beauty that you're seeing in it. But we're not like, they weren't like forcing it upon you. It was just a gentle reminder, which I really, really liked. And the acting was so good. And the references to like books and essays and stuff, I thought that was done so nicely. It just felt so genuine. And I think a part of that is when you watch it, you don't know if it's scripted or improvised. And I think that plays into how real it feels. Authentic, I think, is the word. Yeah, I don't know. Really liked it. I just watched Black Swan. Girl, she is crazy. That was pretty good. Pretty sick film. What else have I watched? I watched See How They Run. Eh, it was mid, I'll be honest. There's this one scene in Come On, Come On where, he's like telling this kid who is like, I'm fine, everything's fine, I'm fine, I'm fine, I'm fine. And he's just like, dude, it's okay to not be fine. That's okay. It's okay, dog. And it was just really nice. I just really, really liked the film. And I watched it with my dad, and he was like, oh, like it's nice, like wholesome Hollywood. As if that was like a bad thing and films need to be like really deep. And I don't think that's the case. I think maybe I like had an emotional reaction to it, potentially, but fucking loved it, mate. Fuck it, I'm just gonna talk about it. So like rationally I know that it's not a good thing to suppress your emotions. I know that. But I don't think anything emotionally productive can happen if, while I'm stuck at home, I allow these. Do you know what I mean? And like, the thing is, I know that I'm not doing it in the way that I should. I'm not being like, no, I'm love, I'm life, I'm joy, or whatever Hannah says. I think I'm doing it in a way that's just like, fuck off, I'm not feeling these emotions. I know it's wrong, I know it's bad, I know it's gonna bite me in the ass later, but I think, you know what, I don't know what I think. I think we're all just constantly trying to justify how we live our lives. But it's like, to who? Who are we justifying it to? Ourselves? But then if we're just living our lives and we feel okay in that, then why do we need to justify it to ourselves? Because we know it's wrong. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, probably. I just think I will have the means to deal with it better later. I might be delusional, yeah. I might look back on this video in a few months and be like, you fucking idiot. That will probably happen, that usually happens. But I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I just want to do something, I just want to... I just want to make something that means something.